Can you please stand with us today?
This morning. Thank you, Jesus. Sing grace. Grace.
than snow. You have redeemed and made me whole.
Sing it again.
Grace, you showed me grace. You lifted my shame. You draw me with loving kindness. Wash whiter than snow. You have redeemed. Triumphed over death and you
first service, we had a word from Frank, who's on our prayer and prophetic team. So we're going to go ahead and replay that video from first service at this time. You guys can turn your attention to the screens.
Here at New Song, we believe that the gifts of the Holy Spirit are still for today. To encourage, to edify, to restore, and to heal. Today, Frank has a word for the Lord from us. Frank is part of our prayer and prophetic team. He is also an elder here at our church.
Be still. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and come away from the world's insistence on your time. Break away and come and sit with me. Let me tell you of the plans I have for you. Let me tell you of my love for you. Be still and know that I am God.
Amen. So that is a word. What that is a word from the Lord that was spoken through Frank to us. So during this next song, let that sit on our hearts. Let us reflect on that of being still. Let us take a moment, let us take a breath, and just pause and let Jesus work on our heart.
Would you all stand with me as we continue our worship today? For we trust.
Stronger. is greater. We can do all things. All those against him will fall, for our God is stronger. He can do all things. No higher name we can call, for Jesus is
but to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
There's no sin too black and no darkness too thick, no chain too heavy for you. We thank you that you invite us to work beside you, to come alongside you and do your work here. We just praise you so much that you love us like that, that you invite us to do work with you. I just pray a blessing over everyone here. I thank you so much that they were able to come here today to hear from you. Amen. You may be seated.
We were privileged this morning to dedicate a child to the loving father who gave her. E.H. Peterson says to dedicate someone or something is to set them aside for a special purpose, and that's exactly what we're doing. We're setting this young lady aside for the kingdom of God, for service to our Lord Jesus. In the New Testament, Jesus said, "Let the little children come to me. Do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these." Katie Lumen. Special day, little girl, special day. You smell that?
Smell it.
Smell it. Smell. It's wonderful. Katie, I dedicate you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You are set aside for God's purposes. You are set aside for His love and care. And Mom, I dedicate you, I consecrate you for this very important service of rearing this young lady in the knowledge of Christ. In Jesus' name, make it so, Lord. If you would, congregation, stand with me and let's pray. Extend your hands out toward her. Bow your heads and pray with me. Lord Jesus, protect and nurture this family and strengthen us, their extended family. that we may in turn strengthen, encourage, and uplift them. Lord, you are indeed the Father of the fatherless, and you are the strength and encouragement of every parent who seeks to raise their child with a heart for Father God. Grant your peace, your fortitude, and every blessing to this family. And remind us that good parenting is not so much a skill that we learn as it is the glorious outpouring of your great grace. Rest that grace on this family, Lord, and we will be very careful to give you all the glory. And it is in your name we pray. Amen. Amen. Blessings.
Congratulations, you guys.
Thank you. Good job, Cody.
All right. Well, welcome to everybody here this morning. If you're a guest with us, or if this is your first time here and you were at Trunk or Treat or Movie Sunday, we're really glad you're here with us. If you've been here for a while, you know what time it is. It is Connect Card time. So everybody wave your Connect Card. Grab your Connect Card. It's in the chair in front of you or underneath you. Come on, just like these guys. Show us your cards. We'll wait. Shema, wave them. I can see people back there without cards waving. I can't see everybody. Can't see over here. You guys, somebody go over there and show them how to do it. Wave their card. Yeah, well, we need to have little kids help. Okay, so the Connect Card time. If you're new with us, the reason we do this is because we want to connect with you. We want to follow through with you, and if there's anything we can do on your journey, we'd love to connect with you. On the front of this Connect Card is a bunch of information that we'd love to get from you so we can contact you and connect and follow through with you. The reason I brought these guys up here this morning was because we believe in being a five-generation church, from the youngest of youngest to the oldest of the oldest, and all of us have a part in this. So these guys were willing to come up and help me. So thank you guys for doing that. On the back of the Connect Card, very important, we really believe in the power of prayer. So every Tuesday, the staff fasts and prays over every one of these Connect Cards. At the end of every service, we pray over all of these Connect Cards because, again, we really believe in the power of prayer. So put your prayer request on there. Take a step of faith, put it on there, and we'll agree together with you in prayer. Also, if something God's doing something cool in your life, you have a praise report, you want to put that on the back, we would love to hear that as well. So we're going to listen to some, and if you're watching this online, you can click on that button and do that as well. We're going to watch some video announcements. We're going to give you a few seconds to fill that out. Then we're going to watch some video announcements. You can put this in the tithes and offerings basket as that's passed. If you need more time at the end of the service, you can put it by the drop boxes at the end of the service. So let's thank these guys for coming up and being courageous and helping us. Okay, good job. You're going to do a...
Hi, I'm Tanner, and this is your news to know. Join us today in the Gathering Place at 2:30 p.m. for the Fine Jewelry Fundraiser. Fine will be partnering with Premier Jewelry for this great event. A percentage of the proceeds will go towards Fine to help them with prevention, education, and raising awareness about human trafficking in our state. There will be coffee, snacks, and info about Fine at the event. If you aren't able to attend, you can still buy jewelry in advance and a percentage will go to Fine. Contact freeinternationalnd@gmail.com with any questions. Have you ever wanted to be involved in a church plant? Well, now's your chance. Next Sunday, November 15th, there will be an informational lunch meeting at 1:30 p.m. in room 102 for anyone interested in serving at the United Tribes campus. This is an actual church campus, and that means we need to fill all positions required to run a complete church, whether it be in worship, tech, kids ministry, prayer, greeting, or just general volunteering. If you'd like to be involved, please sign up at the Access booth today. Kingdom Kids is looking for some awesome people to join the kids ministry team. We are looking for people to rock babies in the nursery, play and sing with preschoolers, or lead an elementary age small group. If you have a passion for kids, then please email kids@newsongbismarck.com if you are interested in helping. Share the Love is seeking donations of hygiene, baby, and basic necessity items year-round to distribute to families and individuals in need. For a full list of items, please visit the Access booth. They are also accepting winter coats and gear of all sizes during the month of November to help those who don't have the proper attire to keep warm during the upcoming winter months. All donations to Share the Love can be dropped off in the black bins in the gathering place or front foyer. We are extending the application period for the E4 internship program. If you're ready to go that extra mile and dive into a great discipleship program, there is still time to look over the program and take necessary steps to grow deeper in your walk with Jesus and move forward with God's calling to minister. Application deadline is next Sunday, November 15th. And finally, if you have a smartphone, we ask that you please take this time to silence the ringer on it now. But feel free to interact with us on social media through our Facebook page and Twitter. And don't forget to check out our new website at newsongbismarck.com. With new, simpler ways to get involved, serving here at church is now easier than ever. Make sure to check out our list of sermons, classes, activities, and upcoming events. We hope you enjoy it. That was your news to know. Have a great day.
All right, that's exciting. Our new website, make sure you go check that out. Today we have the bittersweet thing to do, which is very biblical and is important for us to do, and that's to send people. If you've been here for any amount of time, you know we really believe in this. And today we're going to be sending Sean Kerfman. He's one of the section pastors, and he's going to be moving to sunny California.
I am.
And so we're excited. So he's going to just share for a moment about section pastors, and he wants to get you guys involved.
You want me to take
I'll
this?
Hold it.
Oh, yeah. You're afraid I'll break the chain.
No. So,
I get you. All right. Well, yeah, I am moving to Southern California, and it's going to be awesome. It's 75 and bright and sunny there yesterday. But section leaders is an awesome job. I don't even consider it a job. It's you get to wear one of these and put your name here, and you just go and meet people. There's fabulous people in this group. I've met a family that has movie night every week, and they have great movies, and they tell me what they are, and I talk to them, and they have great kids. And then another time I came in, and there was a gentleman sitting by himself that thought he might have cancer. And I sat down and talked to him, because if you know me, I had cancer. And it's been 16 years, and I'm free of cancer, but I sat with him the next weekend, and I found out he didn't have cancer.
That's awesome.
Yeah, so we were, you know, we all praised him and gave him a great time. So you get to sit and talk to people and find out what's about their life. And if you're kind of thinking, well, I don't talk to people because I can't do that. You know, I can't talk to just somebody I don't know. Well, the song was perfect, Break the Chains. You know, talk to somebody you don't know. They're going to talk back. Or if they don't want to talk back, that's
talk
fine.
Talk back.
Yeah. You know, if they don't want to speak with you, yeah, or talk to you, just go up to them. You've got the badge. They know who you are. Just go talk to them. Speak to them. Just say hi. I don't recognize your face. Is this your first time here? And they'll say, no, I come here every week. I've been here for, 7 years. And, I'm sorry. You know, this is my first time. Thanks for talking to me. So it's a great thing to do, and if you're interested in it, you just go outside here, and they're on the
access booth there.
Yep, and just tell them that you want to do this.
They'll
it's
take
really
it from there.
It's really easy to do, and I found out people, you know, if you saw me at baptism, I found out the gentleman, I didn't even know it was him, that was the guy that edited it for me. You know, I thought it was somebody else, but by talking to him, I found out he's the one that did it. So, you know, you just have to greet people, say hi. Let them know that they're welcome to come here. This is a great church, by the way. And I'm probably going to cry because I do that. And
you don't have to cry to be a section pastor, though.
That's right, yeah.
Or lead a section.
But it works. But this is a great church, and I just love everybody here. And I'm going to miss everybody.
Yes, well, and so that's how it's supposed to be. In the Bible, It's a bittersweet thing to send somebody. He's going to miss us, and we're going to miss him. That's how it's supposed to be. So would you guys just extend your hand out to Sean, and we'll send him to California. God, we come to you according to your word. Lord, we send him from this body, this church, your church in Bismarck, to California. Lord, the blessing that he has been to us here, what you've done in his life, in and through him, Lord, we pray that will only multiply. as he moves to California and that area that he's in, that his light will touch many people, and there'll be just a great thing that'll happen there, just like it did here in him and through him in the church there in California. So God, we love him. We pray that you provide everything he needs, protect him as he travels, and we trust it all to you, and we ask this in the matchless name of Jesus. Everybody said?
Amen.
All right, let's send Sean off with a clap. It's always fun to send people, and yet it's always hard too. And so if you want to get involved in being a sectional leader, please let us know. We'd love to help facilitate that. If you want to grab your outline there, we're going to fill that out together in our Go series. You saw on the video announcement, it said, it told you about our new website, which is really cool. I want you to all check that out. Also today, we're really excited. We get to reveal our new logo, our new church logo, which now it may be like, big deal, whoop-de-doo. Well, there's much more to the logo than just a symbol. So take a look at this video here about our new logo.
Connect. We connect with others. We connect to our community. We build relationships to last. Most importantly, we connect to Christ in our worship, in our giving, and in our fellowship. Grow. We take time to grow in our spiritual disciplines by learning from the Bible, taking part in weekly classes and small groups, and developing our spiritual giftings through testing, evaluation, and action. Serve. We serve others first. We treat each other as we would ourselves. We serve in our church and in our community through outreach and activities. We go forth and make disciples of all nations, and we send our very best. This is the DNA of New Song. We connect, grow, and serve. We do it all in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and we are always striving towards forward motion. New Song Church, connect, grow, serve.
Good job, tech team, Greg. So the logo isn't just a logo. It really represents who we are and where God has taken us as a church on this journey. But it all starts with our relationship with God, our love for him. It doesn't even really start with our love for him. It really starts with his love for us. In this series that we're in called Go, one of the things we always have to remember, and I don't know about you, but sometimes I need reminders. It's not so much I need to learn new stuff as much as I need to be reminded of the stuff that's really important. And so in our series Go, one of the main things that we have to remember is we can and should go to God for and with and in everything. To go to God for everything, anything that happens in our life. Because he loves us. Look at this first verse. It's on your outline there. It says, we love him, not because we're cool or smart, but because he first loved us. Read this with me. Ready, set, go. We love him because he first loved us. This is hugely important because our relationship with God isn't primary. Our relationship with God is exclusive. It's on your outline there. Our relationship with God isn't primary. It's exclusive. In everything we do, he created us, he loves us, so therefore we should reciprocate and love him back in everything we do. So how do we go about doing this? One of the series verses that we have for this series is Matthew 28. Take a look at this, and I'm just going to read through. I'm going to point out a couple things here after we read through. It says, therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you, and surely I am with you and for you always to the very end of the age. And I added "and for you" because that's really implied here. To the end of the age. So I'm going to have you with your pen there, if you like to circle stuff. I want you to circle four words that are key in this series of verses here. It says, therefore, go. So the first one to circle is go. This word go here has to do with exclusivity of our life. Everything in our life. In all of our goings. In all of our goings, everywhere, everything. Second word is make. Go and make. This word make is where we get, this is the Greek word is didasco. And that's where we get our English word didactic, which has to do with to teach. This says go and make or go teach. Do you feel competent enough with the Bible and with your faith to teach somebody something? God wants us to be able to be ready and able to share our faith with somebody. If you don't know how to do that, we've got classes and pastoral care. We'll help. Just get involved and we'll help you in that process. And to make what? The third word here is the circle is disciples. This word can be kind of freaky, but the simple definition of the word disciple is so easy. It's learner. That's it. Go make learners. Can you do that? Again, we'll help. But God wants us to be lifelong learners because he has the best plan in mind for us. But it's work for us. It's work. That's why when we did Trunk or Treat, it's a lot of energy. If you were here for Trunk or Treat, you know it was a lot of work. And same thing with Movie Sunday. It's a lot of work, but it's so rewarding and worth it for us to go make disciples. And the key here in all of this verse, the underlying foundation is, circle this, I am with and for you always. He is with and for us always. He's with us. And the question is, are we with him? Ever been lost before? I'm going to tell you a makeup story here. So it's not true, but just to drive home the point. Let's say that parents, if you're a parent, let's say you have children. We have five children. Let's say that the children went into the woods, the nasty, scary woods, and they got lost. What would you do as a parent? Just say, well, that's too bad. They're kind of a nuisance anyway. No, we go find him, won't we? See, Jesus came and found you and I. If you're a follower of Christ, Jesus found you. And he led you out of the woods. So that's our job, isn't it? Now that we've been found, is to go find others and lead them out of the woods. I have five kids. If I found 3 out of 5, that's 60%. That's pretty good. Or how about 4 out of 5? That's 80%. 80%? Man, that's better than my high school scores. In college, for sure. I did get better along the way, but again, we would not settle. We would turn over every stone, look behind every tree to find those kids and lead them out of the forest. And God did that for us, and he is saying to us, will you do that individually and corporately in your community? That's why we did Trunk or Treat. We had over 3,100 people come through here. It was incredible. You can clap, just you. Okay, now everybody, come on. We're going to clap. Let's clap. We had over 650 people at the Movie Sunday, and it was an incredible. If you haven't seen the movie Woodlawn, man, I encourage you to go and watch it. It's phenomenal. But again, God wants us to follow him in this life. There's a verse that years ago I read this and I was like, what does this mean? It's on your outline there. It's about sheep. It says, my sheep listen to my voice and I know them and they follow me. Okay, let's read this together. Ready? 1, 2, 3, let's go. My sheep listen to my voice. I know them and they follow me. So here, you see this in the wood story? Hey, where are you? I'm over here. Okay, there you are. You're my kids. Okay, now come and follow me out of here. When I read this verse, this word right here, sheep, I was like, what did Jesus call sheep? I know nothing about sheep. What is the big deal about sheep? So this is years ago when I was the youth pastor. I said, I'm going to call around and see if, like, what do sheep do? Do they have a sheep farm? What do they, I don't even know. So I called around, and sure enough, there's a sheep farm not very far from here. And I called the shepherd, and I said, he's actually a sheep farmer, and I said, hey, would it be okay if I brought the youth group out to look at your sheep? And just watch the sheep. And he started laughing. He goes, oh, yeah, it'll be fun. I'm like, what do you mean? He had done this before. He does this. People read this verse and they want to see what's up with the sheep. Because most of us aren't farmers, are we? So we don't know what sheep are. So we gathered everybody up, went to the sheep farm. And he had all the sheep in this big corral, big dirt corral. There's a couple hundred of them in there. And we're all standing around watching the sheep. And it was kind of funny and interesting. And there's this post over on this, on the one fence. And this was all dirt, but there happened to be a couple blades of green grass that had come up by the post. And one of the sheep saw this. And he went over and he started munching on that grass. And for whatever reason, you know, like, kind of like a cow chews his cud, he chewed on that grass and he kept his face down by the post and he just sat there and just chewed. And these other sheep saw this. And they're like, what are you doing over there? This is my animal interpretation of their, what I'm watching happen. And they, a couple of them see that and they're like, what are you doing? And they start putting their face down by the pole and there's nothing there. And more sheep, and there's about 30 sheep trying to get to that pole, and there's nothing there. They're just pushing and pushing and pushing, and I'm sitting there going, what are they doing? And the shepherd's like, they think there's something there, and there's nothing there. Walked over, got a bucket with food in it, and he banged on that bucket. And the sheep went, hey, food! And they all go over to the shepherd, and he pours it out, and they start eating. And I thought about that, and I thought, do I do that? Do I chase non-nutrients in this life? How often do I go to the master and let him feed me? I think I get stuck sometimes. I don't know about you, but sometimes I get chasing things. Second thing that happened that was really interesting with the sheep was he poured out the food and he came over and he stood by me. And I watched as these sheep just would follow him. They would just, they'd always know where he was. They're really good listeners to their shepherd. And this is on your outline there, three keys to having a good relationship with God. That first one is they hear God's voice. They hear God's voice. They know it and they hear it. So do we listen? Do we take time out of our schedule to listen to him? That's a challenge, isn't it? I could tell you, anybody, including myself, show me your calendar. Show me your weekly schedule. Show me where God is programmed into your schedule, and I'll show you a person that has a good relationship with him. Oh, you can't program God. No, you don't have to, because he's everywhere all the time, isn't he? He's the easiest person you'll ever have a relationship with, but how many know that the chaos and craziness of life, if I don't schedule my time with God sometimes, it don't happen, because I'm too busy. I'll fall asleep, and I'll be like, oh, hey, God, I just, and I'm out. And I wake up in the morning, hey, God, and I'm running. So I schedule it in my calendar. I want to hear his voice. If there's one voice we should hear on this planet, it should be that of our Creator. The one who created us, the one who died for our souls, that wants to take us to eternity in heaven with him. If there's one voice we should know, it's that one. Second thing that happened with my little sheep farm escapade, number two on your outline, three keys to having a great relationship with God. So the first one is they hear God's voice. The second one is they allow him, they allow God to push them to freedom. You ever been pushed by God? He might be pushing you right now. So we're standing in the, watching the sheep, and the shepherd comes walking, and he's standing over by me. We're looking at the sheep, kind of comical. And he looks over, and there's this sheep standing by himself up against the fence. He goes, see that sheep over there? I said, yeah. And he goes, he thinks he's stuck. I said, what do you mean? He goes, just watch. Jumps over the fence, goes over to the sheep, and he starts to shoo the sheep away from the fence. He's like, shoo, shoo, go away, go away. And the sheep just looks at him like, can't move. Stuck. And I watch this going, why? What is this sheep doing? So then the shepherd walks over, and he kind of nudges him a little bit, just enough, just kind of move him. And he kind of wobbles, and he's like, I can't move. I'm stuck. I'm telling you. Now, this is, again, my animal interpretation here. This is how it looked, though. That sheep was looking at him like, I told you I can't move. Finally, the shepherd gets over, and he pushes him away until that thing finally lets go, and it reveals this twig sticking through the fence. As the sheep walks away, the twig snaps off. Farmer reaches down, grabs the twig out of his wool, comes over to me and says, this is what he thought he was stuck on. There's a bush that goes on the other side of that fence, And every once in a while, a twig will stick through there. And for whatever reason, sometimes a sheep will go over there. They'll lean up against that, and they'll feel that twig stuck in its wool. And every once in a while, a sheep will think they're stuck. And if I don't go over there and physically move them, they will stand there and not move. So I thought, do I do that? I think I do that. I think I'm stuck, but I'm really not. But I'm glad that I have a God who doesn't leave me there. That he's willing. Hello. Are you glad you have a God that doesn't leave you stuck? Amen. He'll come and push you. But again, in the movie, if you were at the movie, there was this racial tension and all this hell that was happening in this city. And this chaplain was drawing out the players. He was inviting them to something better. And at first, the entire team and the community resisted it. Even though he was pushing. Actually, God was pushing. And they resisted it. Finally, the team relented. And they let go. And God pushed them to freedom. Just like that sheep who got pushed to freedom. You ever need a push? Let him push you. Let him push you. And when he pushes you, just let go. Let him lead you. He'll push you to freedom. The third key on your outline there, it's on your outline, it says, they follow Jesus. They follow Jesus. So we're standing there watching the sheep. They're all standing around. And I'm watching the shepherd. He walks over to the gate. He's done this before. Walks over to the gate. There's this big gate. And he pulls this log, this little log, in front of the gate. He just lays it in front of the gate. Then he opens the gate, and then he walks over the log and through the gate. And guess what happens? All the sheep follow, right? They all follow. And one at a time, they jump over the log. One after another, they're jumping over the log. And so the farmer walks back around as these sheep are jumping through, and he grabs the log, and he slowly pulls the log away. And what do the sheep continue to do? They continue to jump even though the log is gone. And I thought, do I do that? Do I just follow blindly sometimes? Yeah, I think I do. I don't want to do that. You know why sheep do that? Because they're not aware of their surroundings. That's not God's plan. Even though the shepherd was doing that to the sheep to prove a point that we need to listen and follow the shepherd, the good shepherd, our God, is not going to stick a log in front of us for us to jump and waste a bunch of energy for no reason. That's not his plan. His plan is for us to be aware of our surroundings so that we can follow him thoroughly. That's why we did Trunk or Treat. That's why we did Movie Sunday. That's why we do these things. God wants to individually have us follow him to make a difference. Starting here, he loved us first, and then to those that are around us. One of the messages we got, I want to read for you after we did Movie Sunday. Before I do that, though, remember the movie when the chaplain went down front of the bleachers? If you haven't seen this, again, I just encourage you to watch this movie. But he went down front and he does this speech. He talks to the guys and he asked them, do you want to follow Jesus? Do you want to come and join me? And one at a time, they came off the bleachers and they came down front and they joined him. They said yes to Jesus. Have you said yes to Jesus this morning? Are you a follower of Christ? God wants to make an impact in you and through you. Here is one of the stories of the many from Trunk or Treat and from Movie Sunday. It says this. This person wrote and it says, it's been 20 years since I went to church. I was invited to Movie Sunday by a friend, and the movie was very inspiring. It taught me that through prayer, anything is possible. Now I'm ready to forgive from my past hurts, and I'm excited to start going to church again. Life is much bigger than a football game and a movie. It's real people connected to our Creator, our God. And He wants to lead us and guide us. That's what we were created for. For now, on this life, and for eternity. But it takes mature followers of Christ to have a great relationship with God. It's the last line in your outline. Mature followers of Christ have a great relationship with God. Now listen, that doesn't mean I'm perfect or you're perfect. It doesn't make me better than anybody. But it does make me better than I was yesterday and last week and last month and last year. Because a relationship with Christ, that's what births all the motivation. That's what sustains us through everything. And God wants to build that in us. And that means we just need to be close to Him. And how do we do that? Every one of us is different. We're going to pray here and take a moment to reflect on this individually and corporately. What is God saying to you? Maybe you need to carve out time in your schedule and say, you know what, I need to be better at going to church. Maybe I go to church every Sunday, and I know friends that, man, they just don't miss. And I'm not saying that you need to do, but you have to pray through this. Where on your calendar is God going to fit? Is He that much of a priority? Tell you what, you make God a priority, and it won't work. He has to be exclusive. He has to be greater than a priority in your life. He should be involved in everything in your life as your Creator, as the lover of your soul. So how are you going to do that? How are we going to do that? How are we going to carve time out to hear His voice? It's between you and God, but He wants to be there for you. Or maybe it's you're stuck in something, or at least you think you are. And God's He's been pushing you, and you've been resisting, and you know you just need to say, okay, I'm going to move forward with what He's got for my life. Yeah, but what are my friends going to say? Yeah, but what about my family? Yeah, but what about my money? What about the... God will push you. You just have to quit resisting. Let Him move you to freedom. Or maybe it's you've never said yes to Jesus before. You don't consider yourself a follower of Christ, and you want to change that. It's simple. Just like those guys got off the bleachers and went down and met Jesus for the first time and with that chaplain and said yes to Jesus. It's the same thing for any of us. Just to take that step of faith. So we're going to pray. We're going to take a moment. We're going to reflect there. There's some blanks if you want to write whatever the Lord might say to you in these next moments. So would you pray with me? God, we just come to You, and as we think about these things, Your love for us, our response back to You because of it, our ears, are we good listeners to You? How are we gonna make this work? This exclusive relationship with You, our Creator, our God. Help us, speak to us. Maybe it's yes. Today I want to take that step. And I want to follow You out of the forest. Whatever it is, Lord, we just give You these next few moments. We ask that You would speak to us as we reflect on these things. Thank you.
If you'll outstretch your hands with me so we can pray over our connect cards. Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you for everybody who filled one of these out, Lord, for everybody who took a step of faith, Lord. Father, we know that you honor that. We thank you, God, that you are a good God, that you don't turn away from us, Lord, but you bend down to hear your children, Lord, when we speak to you. Lord, we give every single one of these connect cards and lay them before you, God, knowing that you're faithful, that you'll respond, Lord. And I pray that you would just make it obvious to every single person here, Lord, that you would move in their lives, Lord, that you would answer their requests, Lord, that you would show up in their life in a new and refreshing way, Lord, when they desperately need it most. Father, we submit these to you and trust in you, Lord. Thank you for being such a good Father to us. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Well, like Kurt said, if you're here today and you feel a tug on your heart, a realization, you want to say yes to Jesus, we have some people that want to help you with that. Right outside these doors, there's a big orange sign that says yes, and that's where you'll find people who just want to guide you into making this decision. They want to pray with you, get you a free Bible, and just give you some of the next steps that you take now that you're on this journey. And if you're here and you want prayer for anything that you're going through in your life, no matter what it might be, we're going to have prayer teams here to the left of the stage available for you at that time. And if you are walking through something difficult in your life, we want you to know that you can take advantage of something here called the Pastoral Care Team. These are people that will sit down with you one-on-one and just listen to anything that you're going through in your life. They'll offer you godly wisdom and advice and help get you connected to any other resources that you might need, because we want to be able to walk with you with what you're going through. So to take advantage of that, just call our church office or go online to newsongbismarck.com. And also, if you've been coming for a while, if you've been a believer for a while and you want to get involved, you want to play the game on a higher level, you want to do something to serve a higher purpose to help us expand the kingdom and tell more people about Jesus, there's lots of places in this church here that you can get involved in serving. We're sure to have a place that's fit for you. So to do that, we just ask that you fill out a servant leadership app. The best place to get started for that is just to go to our website, again, newsongbismarck.com, and click the serve button, and that'll be the best way to get you plugged in wherever you want. Other than that, if you guys will stand and we'll close with the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Thank you all for coming. Have an awesome week.